That's gonna be an interesting fight. If Devin Dubity's supposed to do, that's a big, that he's up there now. It's like, okay, I'm out there. I beat an experienced fighter.
Yeah. By the way, did you see the new music video of Snoop?
Nah.
You gotta see it, Calvin. You could have played a stunt double.
Everybody said that to me. Me and him look alike. I ain't meet him yet.
You gotta meet him. Hopefully he'll be here for the fight. You guys can do a face off. I think you're the same height, same everything.
I think he's taller than me.
You taller?
I think he's taller than me. But everybody say we look alike.
Okay, Kenny, this is what I don't like about boxing. Joshua loses to Usyk. Joshua got exposed. What's his name? Lomachenko loses to Teofimo. Loma got exposed. Teofimo loses, Teo got exposed. You don't get exposed. One fight is not. Listen, everybody can have a bad day.
Yeah, no, that's
and,
true.
And the
that's
fight true. Was very close
one
with Teofimo.
One loss don't
define you?
Yeah.
One it loss. Depends on how you, like, he went out on the shield. When you got a fighter that actually quit, now that's different. That defines you.
But all three went out, you know?
They all went out on the shield.
So why are people talking smack? Just the culture we live in?
Right, yeah, it's just the culture. It's the difference when a fighter quit. You know what I'm saying?
I don't think one loss defines who you are.
Teofimo is a great fighter.
Yeah.
I think so.
Some fighters are over dramatically injured.
It's just I believe this day and time with these youngins, you know what I'm saying? They on that undefeated shit.
Yeah.
You know.
Always set the bar high, you know?
Yeah, basically.
But it's okay, listen, I'm not gonna say it's okay to lose because nobody wants to lose, but it's part of life.
Yeah.
Winning and losing. You can't think your life's over.
But we had some great champions. This big great champions that
Floyd is everybody's idol in this era. So they feel like they lost, they feel like they're not good as Floyd. They hurt. That's all it is.
But like they said, Floyd set the bar.
Floyd set the bar.
He said that joint Superman high.
Yeah. It's history, man.
But Floyd is Floyd. One time I interviewed Kobe. What's up? One time I interviewed Kobe and I said, Kobe, are you the next Jordan? Magic Johnson walked by and said, no, he's the first Kobe. Don't ever try to be somebody else. Be yourself.
Yeah.
Be the first Tank.
I told Floyd that one day when we was training.
Yeah.
I said, Floyd, Tank, it's not you. You know what I'm saying? He's not you. He's just him.
Oh, God.
I said, but he's been studying you since he was a baby, you know?
Yeah. No, that's true.
Yeah, that's true.
By the way, how did you and Tank meet, Calvin?
Well, Tank was in the gym and my son used to train him. And my son used to be at the table telling me about Tank all the time.
He was 5 years old at the time?
Huh?
How old was Tank?
He was little. Tank was a baby. And then he used to watch his other kid named Ramon Manley was my first national champ.
Wow.
And they used to go at it all the time. And so when I used to train Ramon Manley, he used to watch and sit there and watch us all the time. So when my son went back to Jersey, he told Tank something. I don't know what he told, but he told me, he said, yo, stay in that little kid's, you know, life.
Wow.
And then we just came on something, you know. Man, he's me, and I'm him.
Eminem is in the house.
You call him Eminem.
Have you seen 8 Mile?
Yeah.
8 Mile. Have you seen the movie 8 Mile?
Have I seen the movie? Of course I've seen the movie 8 Mile.
You only get one chance, one opportunity.
He rabbit.
He sound like him.
It's a great movie. Elliot is a great. He's a great cook, great chef. He does a good job. Responsible.
So that's how Tank came in my life, man. You know, it's been like this since God day.
But it's very tragic because I've been to your gym where a lot of young gentlemen passed away.
Yeah, he's been around death.
A lot.
He's seen like 6-7 kids die that was in the that was training beside him every day.
In the streets, just from shooting. They're like innocent bystanders are just.
It's just like when my son died. We brought him back to Baltimore. It was a show that we wanted to do at the Cop State. And that was the first show. We was waiting to do that show. We brought Tank back, sold out. I guess home, my son died. You know, so.
And Calvin, people tell me that when you lose a son or a daughter, you never get over it.
No, it hurts. It definitely hurts. Like, Tank had another brother named Rock, Ronald Gibbs. It was like his oldest brother, you know what I'm saying? And right now, every time I talk about Rock, I still get emotional about
him. He also passed away.
Rock was a good kid, you know?
Baltimore is a very rough place.
Yeah, it's rough.
It's home, it's you know.
It's rough, but again, how would I sit there and say, that's how every city has its ups and downs.
Absolutely, correct.
You know?
Yep. That's true. But you're doing a big thing, taking these kids, preventing the next victim and making them stars and champions. And they don't have to be boxing champions. They're champions in life. But as long as they stay good.
Tank did something, man. We just did the first GTD pro amateur show. It was all amateurs, but they came out like they was
amazing. Pro, how many people were there?
It sold out.
And you had your own belts and everything. Man, it was great.
The belts that I gave out, they collector's items. They got Baby Frank on it. You know Baby Frank.
Of course, rest in peace. He was the best, Calvin.
Yes.
Never said a bad thing about anybody.
Nobody. He's all when I and for always, him to be younger than me and I used to cry on his shoulder. Wow.
You know, he was always in the shadows. Nice guy.
He used to say, "Man, they're your little youngest, man. They're growing."
He used to always tell me, Ellie, let's hang out, but no videos.
Yeah.
Good dude, man.
Man, so we did that show, man. It was a great show, great time turnout. Thank you for the city of Baltimore supporting the kids. Now we gotta do another major move with the finances that we got from the show. You will see it. Stay tuned.
I mean, listen, thanks not only a star in the United States, worldwide star.
Yes, yeah.
Only three fighters in boxing history were champion at three divisions at the same time. Armstrong, Canelo, and Tank. That's it.
In the history book.
And no one, listen, it's very hard to take a kid. Freddie Roach has never done this. Take a kid that never threw a punch and made him a champion.
Right.
Pound for pound fighter.
That's true. And won normal tournaments with the same kid.
Yep. Because there's no money in amateurs. You lose money. You spend money on gas, hotels.
Tank told 40, he said, "Man, you get Calvin $1 million, he's going to spend it all back in boxing. He's going to give it to the kid."
Why not, you know?
Can't take it with you.
But Calvin, your life story is fascinating as well. Obviously, anybody who watched The Wire, what character was based on you?
One that came home and started the gym.
That's crazy.
Yeah.
The kids were in the show too, right? From the gym?
Yeah, all our kids.
How come?
Was in the show.
I ask the messed up question?
What?
When I first started coming around, the bags in your gym were taped with 1,000 layers of tape. And I called companies to donate your equipment, and they all refused to donate.
Yeah. I don't know why.
But you're doing a great job. They should have had to, how many bags do you need?
And
how
they
many?
Know.
Now you got tanks, and
they've been one of our sponsors.
Now, yeah.
They've been one of our sponsors. They could have been on the bandwagon because we know they've been with us from the beginning.
Exactly.
Yeah, shouts go off to Box Raw. Gotta give them their props. They look out for us. You know?
They're good people.
They said, like,
their sweatsuits are the best.
They sent me a whole bag of hand wraps to give out to the kids and water bottles for the fight.
That's cool.
Yo, Under Armour, Under Armour clothes all my kids.
But yeah. Kevin, how did you get into boxing? What was your...
Well, I had a friend named Warren Boy Lee and Reggie Gross. Reggie Gross fought Mike Tyson.
Wow, did he win?
No, you don't remember that fight? He came out dumping, didn't he, Kenny? Yeah. He came out dumping on Mike. Mike was... Then Mike just, boom, caught him, knocked him out. So Reggie watched me box one day. I used to always kickbox. That was my thing.
That was your thing?
Yeah, my thing was kickbox. And so Reggie seen me. We was locked up together. So he said, "Man, you should be a fighter." I said, "Man, time I get out of here, I'll be an old man." And I came home, the one that introduced Tank to me, my son, him and my nephew was in the basement hitting the bag. And I was like, "Yo, who taught you how to fight?" And I took him to the gym. Next thing I know, this is
you. You were in the gym. But to become a great trainer is not easy. No, you're a dad, a mom, you're a friend, you're an uncle, you're a financial supporter, you're
Kenny
everything.
He always tell me, keep my cup empty. You know what I'm saying? I don't mind watching other great coaches work.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? I don't mind watching other coaches work, you know what I'm saying? Because we all teach the same thing but different methods. You know what I'm saying?
Okay, if you ever make $100 million, you know what you have to buy, Kenny?
What?
A zoo.
Yeah, he likes animals.
He loves animals.
He loves animals. How you doing, bro? He loves animals.
What's his favorite animal?
I don't know, he got so many of them.
I like the pit bull terrier.
Pit bull terrier, they're loyal?
They're loyal.
You're all fighting a pit bull right now.
All dogs are loyal.
That's true.
With this pit bull we going into on Sunday, he's a little wild, we gotta tame him.
Yo, that's a good one. So
guys, there you have it, Coach Calvin Ford over here. And Calvin, how many national champs have you made over the years?
Shut up.
Too many to count?
We had a lot of
Yeah, close to 40.
Man, yo, we've been rolling.
And he did it. In 16 years.
Wow.
Out of one jab.
And kids that never threw a jab.
That's why
never
I call him the Bible. Everybody
he knows.
I call him. He knows all that stuff.
Yeah. He did it in 16
Everybody
years.
Everybody said, "Yo, you're Kenny tight." I said, "That's my Bible, man. I read him every day." He fucks me out sometimes.
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
So they want to know.
So there you have it. Stay tuned. Feast report.com and Seckbach reporting.